4 years after watching Donald Trump inflict wounds in a practical trade war with China, the US President Joe Biden appears to have done the same, almost maintaining a stand saying that his economic views on China are no different from Trump's. The master on the chessboard may have changed, but certainly not the tactics and objective, even though the game is played with stricter rules. Could this move by the US and the Biden administration mean a setback in China's technological ambitions by as much as a decade? Or does this signify the start of something new for the Chinese industry? These and many more questions will be addressed in this video, so make sure you stick around till the end. Where better to start than from the horse's mouth? In a recent statement, ASML's chief executive officer Peter Wenning stated clearly that China was unlikely to replicate the leading lithography technology the company produced. He, however, did not rule them out, stating that unlikely to replicate did not mean impossible, as China will definitely try. What exactly is he on about, then? Well, he opined that it would take them as much as 15 years, giving them the same amount of time it took Peking to carry on its research on EUVs from the 1990s. In case you're lost, Advanced Semiconductor Materials Lithography Holding is the largest semiconductor industry supplier, controlling a monopoly in the supply of EUVs and extreme ultraviolet lithography photolithography machines, globally. Everyone has their opinion on seemingly everything. So what do the majority think about ASML's monopoly? For the larger percentage, many individuals question ASML's monopoly. But why? We mean, there are a few other firms in the world that manufacture EUVs, so what makes ASML different? Simple, ASML has a monopoly position as the sole supplier of cutting-edge lithography equipment in the world, and the increase in demand for its chips, as well as its robust pricing power, which all benefits the company's expansion exceptionally well, are the major reasons why ASML seems unaffected by the lull suffered in the semiconductor industry, from the US prohibition of semiconductor sales to China, it's a monopoly and the increase in demand. What's more, well, EUVs, which are used to manufacture the most advanced, high-tech chips, use tiny rays of light to pattern the finest precise details on silicon pieces that form semiconductor chips. Our point exactly is this: because EUV lithography can pack more transistors onto a single chip, these chips can be mass-produced affordably. They also have more processing brain power, less energy, and higher performance, enabling most of the world's improving technology, including smart cars, smartphones, homes, augmented reality, and voice recognition solutions. Other companies may produce EUVs, but none can come close to the cutting edge that ASML brings to the table. ASML alone accounted for 46% of EUV sales in 2021, producing 80% of the world's EUV lithography machines. And so for ASML to say it would take the Chinese tech industry and anyone else 15 years to emulate their EUV lithography machines, you know, that definitely packs a punch. Going forward, following a report in April 2021 by the Semiconductor Industry Association and Boston Consulting Group, amidst growing international economic and political tensions between the US and China, it warned that export rules encouraged China to develop its own alternative chip machinery. Seeing and claiming the Chinese to be a threat to its economic system and national security, the United States opted for a ban against China, preventing the sale of US semiconductor materials and their components to China. That's just wild. Of course, this sent shockwaves down the spine of the semiconductor industry, as every company was affected by the loss of a major player in the global market and industry. The Chinese government would retaliate and take its own measures against the United States, as bilateral and trade relations would only worsen between the two countries. Guess they got the point back. You're probably wondering how this ban has affected China? Or how important is this technology to China? To start with, the dependence on foreign lithography equipment emerged as a growing liability for Chinese industrial chipmakers. But for China, it wasn't just about imposing sanctions on the US or retaliating in the face of tightening US-led export controls, but it was also about making a substantial return in chip manufacturing of the finest quality. A goal that had been long set by the Chinese government, but is still in progress. Knowing the major aspect the Chinese had not perfected yet in chip technology was the etching of precise patterns on silicon wafers, the United States seemed to shut them out from making technological advancement in that area, using the country's Achilles heel against it. Being highly reliant on foreign aid within this area, China desperately needed to find a way out. What did the government do then? They began their search for the next major step in the domestic production of EUVs at home. What is left to know is the response from the Chinese and if Achilles would ever find a remedy. On that subject, you must know that China is developing its semiconductor industry on the foundation of its national strength. In order to develop and materialize the production of EUVs, China has outlined three major courses: the optical objective lens, light course system, and dual stage system. Oh yeah, at present, Peking University, a public research university in China located in the capital city of Beijing, has broken through the core of the optical objective lens. How have they managed to pull that off? The university is primarily funded by the government through its Ministry of Education, so it hasn't been much of a surprise that the institute had so much financial power to chase this project, as the funds from the government are enough to cater for such an expensive project, which took ASML over 15 years while spending over 6 billion euros. How influential is Peking's role in all this, then? Ranked as one of the top academic institutes in China and the world, coming 16th globally as of 2021, Peking is a breeding ground for most of China's top talents, playing a pivotal role at the center of major intellectual movements in China. On its 121st founding anniversary, it unveiled its Global Excellence Strategy, an international blueprint aiming to enhance Peking University's global presence during the Fourth Industrial Revolution. The plan aims to strengthen international cooperation, overcome development barriers, and assemble global resources. So you see, while this is an optimistic take from one of China's most foremost universities, the breakthrough of this achievement does not mean that China has broken through the EUV lithography machine. Here's something even more exciting or shocking for you, depending on whose side you're on. Peking isn't the only driving force in China's search for the localization of this technology. Far from it. On May 6, 2021, the Chinese media reported a technological breakthrough in three technological areas, despite the Chinese epidemic lockdown, which could not halt the nation's hunger and drive for technological advancement. The Shanghai Institute of Optics and Fine Mechanics made bolstering progress on the N41 neodymium glass, mastering the scanning perspective electronic display mirror technology. This was a positive addition to the nation's realization of the localization of EUV lithography machines in the future prior to the Peking University breakthrough. The Shanghai Institute and Peking University bring China closer to its goal of local EUV industrialization and spell trouble for the United States and ASML. For China, its semiconductor journey started in the 1990s, but its designs had always been years back when compared to that of the United States. This progress would mean a lot of positive for the nation and its industrial market. Concentrating mainly on integrated circuit designs and due to its 30-year-long journey, China has grown into a significant player in the global technological space, accounting for nearly 13% of the global IC design market in 2020. The breakthrough in extreme ultraviolet lithography machines would enhance China's already improved international prestige and global influence, even in the international market. Once again, this will undoubtedly enable China to once showcase its strong scientific talents and research strength to the world. At a time when scientific and technological development is on the rise, becoming an increasingly significant factor in the competition for comprehensive national strength in the international market, it would be necessary to improve China's prestige. As China is on the verge of realizing the localization of EUV lithography machines in the future, it is very likely that ASML will eventually lose out to China, something CEO Peter Wennink expected. He said China's actualization of this goal would put ASML and the Western markets, i.e., Europe and America, out of the market or its monopolistic position. And let's not forget the low cost of production of the Chinese industry, especially when we look at the fact that all of China's materials used in making its EUVs may be homemade compared to that of ASML, which gets its parts from multinational corporations. The cheaper cost and availability of materials can easily mean lower prices for the Chinese and its market and consumers, which would be slightly or totally different from ASML's prices depending on the cost of things and the goal of the Chinese. Nice, are we in this for profit, or would we love to put ASML and America out of business? That would be something we should definitely watch to see the Chinese response. The US did shut China out of an emerging market, as this high-tech chip has a lot to do with emerging technology, including electronic vehicles. With about a billion petrol-driven vehicles in the world today, that figure is expected to fall significantly by 50% by 2030, implying that there is an emerging market to provide about 500 million EVs between now and the end of this decade. The US wants its manufacturers to control the more significant portion of that, at least in the countries where it has political sway. China seems to be a country that would want a large bite of this piece of pie and many more. The United States and China definitely have their eyes on this space, so those ASML. But the question remains, who would triumph? Only time will tell. We're sure you enjoyed this video, so make sure you like and comment on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications, so you don't miss our other videos.